Hi, everybody. Dan Illman taking a look at race number 7 at Del Mar on Saturday. It's the Grade 2 Seabiscuit Handicap. We're going a mile and a 16th on the turf. And like the other graded stakes race at Del Mar on Saturday, this is a wide open field where probably the favorite is going to be a fairly middling price, maybe 7-2, 4-1 on the morning line. It's a race where you could try to find some value and perhaps make a little bit of a score. It's probably a spread race in multiple race wagers. The horse that I want to key in here on is the number 10, Ohio. And I know what you're saying. Ohio was dropped in for a tag 3 starts back. He was claimed away for $50,000. How good could he possibly be? Is he really a graded stakes horse? And those are all legitimate questions, to be sure. But it also will probably inflate Ohio's price a little bit come post time. If you look back over Ohio's overall form, he's a horse that my colleague Matt Bernier and I always liked when Paulo Lobo had him back in 2016, 2017. He was third in the Del Mar Mile behind Midnight Storm. He ran a couple of nice races in stakes competition, but he was always his own worst enemy. He was always rank out of the gate and pulling very hard. And it seems as he's gotten older, he's at least cured those tendencies. In his first start off the claim for Mike McCarthy, he was able to sit way off of the pace against claiming foes, but he did win very nicely. And last time out in the City of Hope Mile, a Grade 2 race, it was an ambitious spot that McCarthy put him in. He ran really well. There was no pace in that 1 mile race. He came with an even run to finish third behind the two favorites, Sharp Samurai and Fly to Mars. Both of those horses would be very, very dangerous and would take action in this race. I think Ohio is cycling back to his good form. I think Michael McCarthy has figured him out, and I think he's going to be a solid price in here, and he has enough tactical speed, if need be, to stay within range if the pace is moderate. He is adaptable. I think Ohio is an interesting horse and a horse that should definitely be considered in any kind of multiple race wagers. Caribou Club down towards the inside might be more of a 6.5, 7 furlong horse, but I think he can get a mile into 16th under the right circumstances. He draws an inside post here and should be able to save some ground. He's a horse that's probably going to need some pace. Last time out in the Eddie D Stakes, it was a really tough spot, to be sure. I mean, he was running against Stormy Liberal, who came back to win the Breeders' Cup Turf Sprint for the second year in a row, doing so with a 119 buyer speed figure. There was also another next out winner in the Eddie D. Caribou Club was near the back of the pack. He angled out. He came with the run. He just couldn't get to Stormy Liberal. And the Del Mar Mile 2 starts back. I thought he got pinched back from mid-pack in the early portion of that race, had to come widest into the stretch. I don't think that race is as bad as it looks. Caribou Club is a graded stakes winner at Woodbine, going one turn at 7 furlongs. He does have some fast races. The last race, the Eddie D, earning a 120 time form U.S. speed figure, 103 buyer speed figure. And he's another horse that has to be considered. The number 2 big score is very, very consistent. And while the Shadwell Turf Mile this year just didn't seem the strongest Shadwell Turf Mile we've seen in recent years, it has produced some decent performances. The 4th place horse returned to finish 3rd in the Breeders' Cup Mile with a 100 buyer speed figure. Big score came from the back of the pack. He got a nice pace set up. He finished and passed a few horses in the stretch. I think those East Coast turf horses might be just slightly stronger than the ones on the West Coast. Now he gets back to the West Coast. He gets back to firm going. He likes Del Mar. He needs pace. He's a one-run closer. If he doesn't get pace, he's in big trouble. If he does get a little bit of pace, Big Score is a horse that you can count on to come with a late run, and he's one worth considering. If you believe the pace isn't going to be fast, and I think there are horses with varying degrees of early speed and tactical speed that Timeform US has out there on the lead, you might want to consider the 8 Kenji Storm, because I think Kenji Storm is going to make the lead in this spot, and I think there's at least a chance that he gets away with an easy middle quarter mile. Kenji Storm was not able to hold off the winner most recently in the restricted Lure Stakes, and it's kind of been the story of Kenji Storm's career. More seconds than firsts from 34 lifetime starts. But Phil D'Amato's had him in pretty good form. Second in the Charlie Whittingham back in May. I was really disappointed in his Del Mar handicap race 3 back. Mile and 3/8 probably not his game. Then the Eddie D, 6.5 furlong, probably not his game. He's a middle distance horse. He's a miler. He's a mile and a 16th type. He's going to get that here. I've always had a thing for Kenji Storm. I'm not sure he's a graded stakes caliber horse. I know he will be a good price, and I do think there is a chance that he can at least get out to an early lead and relax a bit while setting those fractions. Those are 4 horses that I think you should consider in multiple race wagers. Let's talk briefly about some of the other horses in this race, beginning with the 3, Ann Arbor Eddie. And this horse just has a lot of guts. He's going to fight you hard all the way to the wire, and sometimes he's good enough, and sometimes he's not. He was beaten last time out going 6.5 furlongs by a decent runner in law-abiding citizen. He has sort of found his niche in the mid to high 90s from a buyer's standpoint. He may need to run a little bit faster to win a race like the Seabiscuit. He is a horse that Timeform US has close to the pace. He has the tactical speed to work out a good trip under Mario Gutierrez. I just wonder if at this stage of his career, he is truly a graded stakes horse. But I really respect the guts that he shows each and every try. The four is Pin Check, coming in from Europe. And this is a horse that ran third in a Group 2 stakes race last time out at a mile. And while the winner of that race came back to, I believe, run fourth in a Group 1, the rest of that field has not done much in subsequent starts. A Group 3 winner two starts back, Pin Check attracts Mike Smith, which means Pin Check will attract a little bit of money in this race. He, I have a feeling, is going to be a horse that needs some pace. Many of these European horses do not break well, and they like to come from the back of the pack. Pin Check did show speed in some of his races. It'll be interesting to see if Mike tries to put this horse on the lead, given an alert break. I'm not sure he's got a Kenji Sorm sort of early foot. Holiday Stone is a horse that folks, I think, should consider at a really interesting price. This is a horse that showed some ability back in 2017 as a three-year-old, finishing second in the Transylvania Stakes, third in the Columbia at Tampa Bay Downs. It was always sort of a nibbler in those spots. He ran the Mathis Brothers Mile in his final start as a three-year-old, did not run very well, went away for 8 months. Returns to the races, gets a win at Saratoga going a mile with a 120 Timeform US speed figure, a career best 96 buyer speed figure. And I believe those figures were validated when three of the horses Holiday Stone vanquished that day came back to win their very next starts. Holiday Stone then ran on dirt in his most recent start. It was sort of a weird spot from George Weaver, and he didn't run well. It was his dirt debut. Just draw a line through that race. It's not his surface. He's getting back to turf here. He's switching to Flavie and Pratt. And I think this is a horse that can be tactical enough to get the jump on the true closers. Don't sleep on Holiday Stone at a big price. Madame Stripes is a mare taking on the boys. You could argue she's taken on slightly better competition. I mean, no one's been able to beat Vasilika in the filly and mare turf division in Southern California as of late. Madame Stripes last time out sort of fell behind a tepid early fractions. Came with a good run to finish third. She's an in and outer. She sometimes wins. She sometimes runs second or third. She has more seconds and thirds than wins in her career. She can be forwardly placed. She can also come from the back of the pack. I think this spot is a little bit tough. I think this distance might be a little bit sharp. I know she won the megahertz at a mile. I wonder if she's a little bit, better at a mile and an eighth than this mile and a 16th distance. Synchrony might actually be the favorite in this race. And I might fade Synchrony a little bit if he is a shortish price. Seventh in the Shadwell Turf Mile, trainer Michael Sidham says did not like the good turf course that day. He's going to get the firm ground to be sure at Del Mar on Saturday. But he also finished behind Big Score that day. And Big Score didn't have to like the good turf course either at Keeneland. He also was the recipient of the fast pace, just really didn't kick with Big Score at the end of that race. His prior starts at Monmouth, good. Over firm turf, good figures, both wins, both graded stakes, look great on paper. You watch those races, he had perfect trips every time saving ground, and he didn't beat much in those races. This is a tougher spot, I believe. And again, we always talk about East going to West, big drop in class. I'm not sure it's the case this time for Synchrony. And I think that Synchrony is going to take money based on the fact that he has really done excellent work since being switched to the turf for Michael Stidham. Wouldn't be surprised if he wins, but to be honest with you, I'm going to try to fade him a little bit at a relatively short price. I think Lacan can crack the board. I think he's been very, very unlucky. I've always liked this horse, and in the City of Hope Mile, I actually gave him a flyer shot to hit the board at 80-1. There was no pace for him to run at. He still ran a little bit to finish fourth. There was no pace in that lure last time out. He was only beaten a length finishing behind Kenji Storm. I'm curious to see what happens if Lacan ever gets pace. It's his third start of the form cycle for Hall of Fame trainer Ron McAnally. I'm not sure he's the best closer in here, but maybe with the right situation, he can spice up your trifectas and superfectas once again. Secretary at War, sixth in the lure last time out. The race two starts back at a mile and a quarter in the John Henry. Maybe a little bit far for him. Three back, he was a winner at Del Mar against non-winners of two other than competition. That's probably more his speed. He has some tactical speed, but this is a horse that, again, doesn't win very often. 3 for 7. 17 lifetime, he'll be a price. He will, another in and outer, so to speak, a horse that once showed immense potential. And again, Matt and I were talking about him in 2016, like he could perhaps go on and be a player in the middle distance division on the turf. It really didn't work out. He was beaten a nose in this race last year. He does his best running at Del Mar. The Eddie D, he really didn't fire going 6.5. His race two starts back at Santa Anita way back in January. I mean, he's had so many problems this year. He will. It worries me, especially when he was a vet scratch on November the 2nd. This will only be start number 4 of 2018 for He Will, and he is saddled with a lousy outside post position. I'm going to give Ohio a little bit of a chance. He'll be my top selection in this race, but I think I'm going to try to spread, and in doing so, I'm going to try to beat Synchrony. I'm going to go 10, 1, 2, and 8 in the Grade 2 Seabiscuit Handicap on Saturday. Best of luck.